it's a fear of failure. And then I think for me, it was also, I gave up a job and I had promised to my parents. I was like, if I try this, like I have to make this work somehow.
Word? What were you trying to be before?
Well, I had a job. It was a consultant. And so like my starting pay for my first year out of college was good. It was good. And so it was giving that up.
Okay.
To try to become a singer.
Right.
Which like my mom flipped out. She was like, that's the worst thing I ever heard.
Dang.
You know? She's like, you're going to throw away 4 years of college education and a job with these benefits.
You were done with all that?
I graduated.
That's like the worst. That's like the worst nightmare for like an Asian
parent. I know. It's not even while you're in school you want to leave. It's done. You have everything in the bag.
Everything. Yeah. And then now she got bragging, right? She's like, you know how much my son's going to make in the starting year? And then you're like, I want to get that up, mom. It's like, no! My bragging rights!
Yo, my mom was like, she was not happy. But I think that's why when I came out here and I quit my job and everything, even to like 2-3 years ago, she's like, you should just go back to your job. You should go back to your job. Because I think she sees the pressure that the industry and I put on myself.
Right.
So it's like this thing of like having to prove myself. I think also I was solo from the beginning. Mm-hmm. Like there was, never had a team member. I never had somebody I looked up to.
True.
And people wrote me off a lot. It was like, oh, he can't really speak Korean. And his singing style's not right. And he thinks differently. Mm. So like, just write him off. And so I remember having to prove myself over and over. So having to go find the songs or write the songs, having to go meet with producers or writers and whatever, right, like network to be like, hey, please use me.
Yeah, like in the beginning, a lot of people just knew you as like an MC.
Yeah.
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 I remember like a lot of my friends that were like interested in him. They were like, oh, you know, like he like MCs and stuff. I was like,
reporter.
Yeah,
I was like, you know, he sings too, right? They're like, really? I was like, yeah, that's why he came to Korea. I thought he was just MC. I was like, no.
But
now everyone knows.
Yeah,
now
but it's I think it was also that pressure of like having to, once you get a job, how do you outperform that so you can become a singer,
right,
public perception. And then once you are a singer, how do you get to a point where you could do the music you want to do?
True.
So for me, it's always like, okay, leveling up as myself to get to what I want to do and where I want to be. I think that's like my internal pressure always.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I think for me too, similar, like with my parents, they never like pressure me to, you know, like make money or be more famous or anything like that. I think because they just know everything that I went through, and they just want me to be happy and just live, be able to support myself on my own out here. So they don't pressure me, but it's just, I think to myself a lot because they're getting older now, and they haven't been to Korea in over 20 years, like 20 years now, and they weren't even able to attend their family's funerals. And for things like that, I just want them to be able, I just want myself to be able to support them so they don't have to work and they could just like come to Korea and just live with their families. And that's why I think I pressure myself to, you know, succeed and like make more money so I can eventually bring them out to Korea. But it's not like they ever say that to me, you know, because they don't want to pressure me and they're fine. But it's just I've been thinking that a lot, which is something that I didn't really think about before. But I think it's just naturally, as you get older, you do think more about your parents and stuff like that.
I think I definitely think that's like a natural pressure that comes to a lot of people. They're kind of like, I want to be able to make enough money so that like my parents, like they could just live comfortably, do whatever they want, and I want to be able to do like whatever I want, like blah blah blah. And I think that's like a natural pressure that most people, I won't say everyone, but like most people kind of puts on themselves.
Right?
Pressure, okay, do you guys feel pressured to get married and have kids already from your parents?
Hell no.
My mom used to.
I mean, she pressures you?
She used to. She used to be like, you know, when things weren't going too well with the whole like career, she was like, just find someone nice and get married and settle down. But now it's just like, put off marriage as late as you can. Yeah. Like, don't get married.
Why? What happened? Where did that change?
Because I think she saw that I couldn't enjoy my young adulthood, you know? Because like, I was like under the contract. I couldn't I didn't really have a life of my own. And she sees how much I'm thriving right now and how much I'm enjoying life. She's like, oh, you can just like live alone for like the next few years. Just get married when you're like late 30s. She actually, I was like, I don't even know if I want to get married. And she's like, that's fine. And I was like, oh, okay.
Hey, did you like this video? If so, click the subscribe button.
And make sure to turn on your notifications so you don't miss a single video.
And listen to the entire audio episode on Spotify or Apple Podcasts. Bye.